Hey my loves, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, welcome, and if you're a new subscriber, thank you for sticking around with me. My name is Chrisepimo. I'm a Nigerian based content creator. Emphasis on I'm a Nigerian based content creator. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about the struggle I experienced being a Nigerian based content creator. Yeah, so that's what I'm going to be talking about in today's video. So this month being the month of March, my channel actually clocked 1 year, and I'm so excited at my growth. Guys, see, I went back to look at my old videos and I could not bring down myself to watch it. See, I also want to give a big shout out to the regular day one subscribers that have been with me and are always watching my video, because when I go through the comment sections, I'm like, oh, this person actually said this to me, this person actually said this to me. And now watching it like a year later, and I'm watching it and I'm like, oh, what was I saying? Why didn't I just cut this piece? Guys, see, thank you if you've been with me since the year 2022. I am so grateful, and I don't take any of you for granted, because seriously, I was saying gibberish. Sorry, the light might be fluctuating about the struggles being a content creator here in Nigeria. Yeah, so without much ado, let's get now straight into the video. So here in Nigeria, we've not really gotten to that point where there is 24-hour power supply. But I think some places in Lagos already have like 24-hour power supply. So I'm talking about the Ibro cities, I'm talking about Lekki, I'm talking about VI, I'm talking about Ikoyi. So those people of those areas actually have 24-hour supply electricity. That's for like a service apartment. But for we that, we don't really stay in the service apartments where we have to pay for NEPA bill, we have to pay for electricity bill, we have, and also study the schedule when the NEPA guys, so if you don't know what NEPA is, it's what we call our electricity guys, if that makes sense. We have to study the schedule of when there is going to be light so we can actually film. And because I don't wait for electricity to film, so I film during the day, I film within the hours of 1 to 2 to 3 o'clock, then I also power on my Lumos lights. You can see my LED lights over there, so I use just one LED light currently, and it just give me a little bit of lighting as opposed to when there is electricity and I have to use the sitting room where there is good amount of lights. Yeah, so one of the struggles we go through being a content creator in Nigeria is electricity. Another struggle I face as a content creator in Nigeria is people perception. God, in as much as I have promised myself that I am going to be true to myself on my channel, I'm going to be very authentic, like I'm going to allow you guys to see the real me on my, just want to let a lot of my subscribers into my life. But people perception, like sometimes most people just want you to create a certain kind of content that you are not even familiar with, that is not your truth. I see, everything I say on my channel is what I do. I'm not saying I'm at the apex, I'm not saying I'm perfect, but this is things I aspire to do, this is things I've already started doing, and this is things that I will keep on doing because I actually want to do this stuff. These are the stuff that tickles my fancy, these are the stuff that keeps me interested, so I am going to stay true to this path. But because people are watching, people just wanted to say, oh Grace, why don't you just go to a Maldives? Who said I don't want to go to Maldives? I can't go to Maldives now because I can't afford it. That is why I have not gone to Maldives. And you want me to go to Maldives and create content? Come on, I can't afford it now. That is why I have not been to Maldives. People perception about your time, people just want to change their own narrative. People want you to do this particular content because this is what they are interested in seeing. One of my best person on YouTube, Amije, should just say, see, let me tell you, Grace, the you in YouTube means showing us your personality. The you means showing us you. Do you, do what rocks your boat. And that has always been my mantra, that I'm going to show what rocks my boat, and I'm not going to pressurize myself to do what other people, like my audience, my subscribers, So, and this is not saying you can't give me a video suggestion. See, I look forward to your video suggestions. That I'm always wanting to create content. If you say, Grace, please do this kind of video, sure, definitely I am going to do, but I am not going to put myself in a tight corner. I'm not going to run into depth because I want to create a certain kind of video for a particular group of people. So I hope that makes sense now. Yeah, background noise is so terrible, guys. See, because there is no constant electricity, you just notice your neighbor when you are filming. Exactly when you are filming, I don't know if they time my movements. Exactly when I'm filming is when they turn on the gen, and there's just too much noise that I lose focus. But because I'm a go-getter and this content creation thing in Nigeria is going to work, I have an app. I'm going to leave like a picture of the app which I use to denoise my video. So after filming this video, I just go straight to that app and just denoise the video. So it kind of kill the background noise a little bit, that you don't get to hear the background noise when I upload this video. So that's another thing we face as content creator here in Nigeria. The background noise is so terrible. Nigeria is a very noisy place, guys, because everybody is hustling 24/7. If you go to the streets of Nigeria by 12 a.m, you are going to see people still walking. Okay, that is an exaggeration, but that is just the truth. That is how Nigerians are hustlers. Like, I have never seen a lazy Nigerian. I think that works. So Nigeria are actually hardworking people, and they are always on the road 24/7. So that's another struggle I face as a content creator here in Nigeria. The background noise, what am I saying, sound? The background noise is so terrible that most times I lack concentration while I am filming my content. The struggle I face after my 1 year being on YouTube as a content creator is boredom. Yes, I'm going to stay true to myself. Most times I get bored of my own content, and I know if you can't sit down to watch your content for about 3 times, that means you're not doing the right thing. Yeah, but not like I get bored of watching myself. I really don't get bored of watching myself. I mean, I'm a very smart talker. I like the way I talk on camera. Yeah, but I get bored of just sitting down in one place. And I think it's a problem a lot of creative actually face, because when they do this thing for a very long time, for a particular amount of time, they just want to do something. Like, they want to switch up things. They want to say, oh, let me do this. They want to test themselves. They want to do this and they want to do that. Yeah, so most time, I think that's one of the struggles I face as a content creator here on YouTube, that I kind of get bored of the kind of content I produce. And I know it's very normal, like, because I'm human and I'm a creative, and it's always very fine for me to want to criticize my own work, because that is where I am going to see growth. That is where I'm going to see, oh, I'm actually lagging behind in this area. I think I should just switch up things. I think I should just do this thing and just, you know, just switch up the game or get bored of my own content most time. And if you're a content creator on this space, totally fine, totally okay for you to, guys, sorry, my hair is scattered. I have a brush just close to me. Yeah, that's how much I like looking at myself while filming. Actually, sorry, I'm not looking at the lenses now. I'm trying to focus here. Okay, yeah, so this is better. Good, thank you. All right, so that is how much I get bored of my own content most time, and I feel like it's very normal, because I'm a creative, I'm a content creator. I always want to do things. I always want to look at my fellow content creators and see what they are doing, and I'm like, okay, I can actually switch up my game to this and just implement music. See, one thing about you being a creator is you are an innovator, whether you like it or not. You are an innovator, and the thing about innovative people is they want to keep on trying new things. They want to see, oh, will this work? Will this not work? Is this good? Is this not too good? Or should I try this? Or should I not try this? So if you're a content creator and you are in this space right now that you are getting bored of your own content, Trust me, it's totally fine. It's totally fine for you to feel this way, because being a content creator means you are an innovator, that you want to keep on trying new things. I think those are the four struggles I experienced being a content creator in Nigeria, or being a content creator after 1 year. So we finally come to the end of this video. If you are still here up to this point and you still want to keep on seeing my beautiful face, please do not forget to give this video a thumbs up, and also leave a comment below. If you're a content creator, I would like to hear from you some of your struggles. And if you are a subscriber and you want to see more topic ideas, you want to talk about a particular topic, please do not forget to leave a comment in the comment section. And if you are yet to subscribe to this channel, please do subscribe, because we have a fabulous time on this channel. So I come your way next time. Stay fabulous and killing it, guys.